This video I will continue KCET haloalkenes and halogens chapter questions. That is the 11th question. Which one of the following is an intermediate in the reaction of benzene with CH3Cl in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3? So the here the answer is C, that is CH3+. Why it is so? What is the reason for this? Now let us learn about this. Here, alkylation of the aromatic compounds with alkyl halide in the presence of aluminium chloride is known as Friedel-Crafts reaction. Means here, alkylation of the aromatic compound. If you take any type of alkylation to the aromatic compound, particularly we are adding in with alkyl halide in the presence of aluminium chloride. So the total reaction is known as one of the named reaction is known as Friedel-Crafts reaction. Here let us see here what is the reaction it is going to involve. Here CH3Cl plus AlCl3. So here the intermediate will form, that is known as CH3+, that is methyl cation. It is going to form, it is losing a Cl ion to that of the AlCl3. So whenever it takes AlCl3, that Cl, so it will forms AlCl4- minus ion. So here what is the question here? Which one of the intermediate it is going to form whenever the aromatic compound it is going to involve? The intermediate will forms is known as here CH3+, that is methyl cation. So next question: which one of the following is not true for the hydrolysis of tertiary butyl bromide with aqueous NaOH? Here the options: A, reaction occurs through the SN1 mechanism. The intermediate formed is a carbocation. Rate of the reaction doubles when the concentration of alkali is doubled. Rate of the reaction doubles when the concentration of tertiary butyl bromide is doubled. So here the answer is option C. What is the reason for this? Because here hydrolysis of tertiary butyl bromide, whenever we are going to take a tertiary butyl bromide, particularly if we are apply the process of hydrolysis, so whenever treated with hydrolysis tertiary bromide with NaOH, it is the one of the important mechanism, that is SN1 mechanism. So here rate of reaction depends only on concentration of alkane. Means here rate of the reaction doubles when the concentration of alkali is doubled. So this is the answer. So next question is: which of the following is not true for SN1 reaction? Options: A, favored by polar solvents. B, tertiary alkyl halides generally react through SN1 reaction. C, the rate of the reaction does not depend upon the molar concentration of the nucleophile. D, primary alkyl halides generally react through SN1 reaction. So here the answer is D. Why it is so? Here, which of the following is not true for SN1 reaction? Because SN1 reaction is favored by bulky groups, must be favored by the bulky groups on the carbon atom attached to the halogens. So whenever the bulky groups are present on a carbon atom, the reactivity it is going to increases in case of SN1 mechanism. Due to that reason, we can say the order of reactivity like this. see here, R3C, X is greater than that of the R2, then or at the same time, similarly, last one, CH3X, means it is indicates that whenever the carbon atom consisting of a bulky group, the reactivity it is going to increases. But here, what they have given here, primary alkyl halides generally react through the SN1 reaction, means it is not true for the SN1 mechanism. So this is the 13th. The next question is, meso compounds do not show optical activity because, here the options are given, they do not contain chiral carbon atoms, they have non-superimposable mirror images, they contain plane of symmetry, they do not contain plane of symmetry. So here, meso compounds, it is indicates that it do not have any chiral images, or you can say that non-superimposable mirror images like that. But here exactly option they have given here, they had given, they contain plane of symmetry, means here the answer is C. See, however, if for example if you take any compound like a meso compound, see here we can observe that A, B, just here see there, no? So D, A, B, C, D, and here A, particularly B and D. See, here it is in one of the optical compound, that to meso compound, optical compound, in that there is a particularly they have taken a here meso compound. So if you observe that here, we can say this is called as plane of symmetry, so that if compound exhibit a plane of symmetry, at that time we can say that that compound it is related to that of the meso compounds. If it is exhibits a plane of symmetry, due to that meso compounds do not show the optically active compounds. So it is indicates that if meso compounds possesses a plane of symmetry and is consequently optically inactive, it is indicates that if it is exhibit a plane of symmetry, it is indicates that the compound it is optically inactive. So next question is, conversion of benzene to acetophenone can be brought by following reaction: A, Wood's reaction; B, Wood's-Fittig's reaction; C, Friedel-Crafts alkylation; and D, Friedel-Crafts acylation. Here the answer is Friedel-Crafts acylation. How it is, let us see here. Whenever conversion of benzene, it must be treated with the acetyl chloride in presence of anhydrous AlCl3. Here there is a formation of acetophenone. Whenever the acetyl chloride it is treated with the benzene, it is directly formation of acetophenone. See here, this COCH3 is going to be treated with the benzene. So here COCH3, and there is a elimination of HCl. So this is acetophenone. So this reaction is known as Friedel-Crafts acylation, because here acyl group going to add to the benzene. So such type of a reaction is known as acylation. Particularly one of the name reaction is known as Friedel-Crafts acylation. So next question is, which of the following pairs are correctly matched? See here, one side they have given here reactant, and another side they have given here products. First one Rx plus AgOH, Rx plus AgCN, Rx plus KCN, Rx plus Na, ether medium, alcoholic and aqueous medium. And here products RH, RNC, RNC and RR. Here the options had given here. Here for the for this question, exactly which type of pairs are correctly matched? See, once if you look at this, which type of pair is correct means D. Why it is so? D means second and fourth. How it is? Let us check it out. Second one, Rx plus AgCN in a alcoholic medium, it gives RnC plus AgX, RnC plus AgX. So it is okay. Then fourth one, the number of alkyl halides, that is 2 moles of Rx, it is treated with the sodium. There is formation of 2 alkyl groups, that is RR, then elimination of 2 NaX. See here, this product, it is exactly matched in the second and fourth options. So the answer is D. So next question is, cycloalkane formed when 1,4 dibromopentane is heated with sodium is, options methyl cyclobutane, cyclopentane, cyclobutane, and D, methyl cyclopentane. Here the answer is methyl cyclobutane. How it is? So by the reaction we will confirm that CH2, 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 CH, CH3, and here Br, and here Br, because 1,4 dibromopentane, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pentane, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So at first position and fourth position there is a situated, or there is a located of bromine groups. So we can say that 1,4 dibromopentane, whenever it is heated with sodium, so what it will get forms, means here there is a elimination, or there is a removal of 2 NaBr, because 2 bromine atoms are there, so we are taking here 2 sodium atoms, so it is removed in the formation of 2 NaBr, means here there is a removal of Br atoms here. So what it will be remaining product here? Only 5 carbon atoms, means only the chain is left, so it will forms in the formation of CH3, then here CH2, then here CH2, here CH2. This means what we will call it as one here, this is a methyl, it contains a bute, that is 4 carbon atoms in the formation of cyclic manner, so that it is named as methyl cyclobutane. So the answer is A. Next is, whenever it is treated with the case of cyclic system, whenever the consisting of one bromine atoms in the presence of it is treated with the magnesium in presence of a dry ether, that is gives a product that must be treated with the, or hydrolysis in the hydrolysis, that is in the formation of H2O, the product will be formed B. So what is the product B? So now let us see here, whenever this is cyclohexane we will call it as one, because there is not consisting of any double bond in the system, so we should not call it as one benzene. So here whenever cyclohexane system it is treated with the bromine plus magnesium, means here which one it is in the answer, that is D. How it is? Now let us see here, cyclohexane, that is cyclohexane Br or bromocyclohexane, it is treated with the magnesium in the presence of dry ether, so what it will get forms, that is formation of an intermediate, that is the MgBr. It is nothing but this is the A. So on hydrolysis for this A intermediate, what it will get forms? Now let us see here. There is a removable of, or there is a detachable of MgBr. So there is formation of cyclohexane. This is known as cyclohexane, and what it will get forms? That is Mg. It is hydrolysis, no, H plus, and here OH minus it is going to forms. So MgOHBr. So the product what it will get forms is known as cyclohexane. Cyclohexane. So the answer is D. So next question is reactivity order of halides for dehydrohalogenation. So here they had given here reactivity order of a halide. So we have to select one answer is the correct answer. So how it is? So option is A, RF is greater than that of the RCl, then RBr, then RI. RI is greater than that of the RBr, RCl, RF. RI is greater than that RCl, RBr, and RF. RF is greater than that of the RI, is greater than that of the RBr, then RCl. So here the answer, the correct answer is option B. Why it is so? What is the reason for this? Because here, as the size of the halide ion increases, the RX bond strength decreases, and the halide ion will be a good leaving group. Therefore, the reactivity order of RI is greater than that of the RBr, then greater than that of the RCl, then RF. Means here we should remember that we should follow the size of the halide ion increases. Whenever the size increases, the halide ion will be a good leaving group. Due to that reason, the correct answer is RI, that is option B. So next question is, which of the following statements is true in case of alkyl halides? So here the options: A, they are polar in nature; B, they can form hydrogen bonds; C, they are highly soluble in water; D, they undergo addition reaction. Here the answer is A. Why it is so? Here alkyl halides are insoluble in water but soluble in organic solvent. So here polar in nature and undergo substitution or elimination reaction. Means whenever you take alkyl halides, it is nothing but one, it will comes under one organic compounds only. Means here halides are exactly polar in nature. Because of that, they can form hydrogen bonds, or they are highly soluble in water. These are the one addition reaction or addition character.